Hey guys, in this video we're going to talk about collagen and the types of collagen. There's actually over 28 different types of collagen. We're not going to cover all of them. I'm going to cover five of them. Okay. Now, what is collagen? It's the type of protein that is the connective tissue. It comes from the Greek word which means glue, because it holds everything together as a mesh, as a like a matrix of strands. Okay. So number one, the type one is the most abundant. 90% of all of the collagen is this type, and it forms scar tissue. It forms the tendons, the ligaments. The bone is made out of collagen with minerals to make it solid. The teeth are also a lot of collagen in there, certain parts, and calcium. And then we have skin and arteries. Okay, that's type one. Type two is all the joint cartilage and the articular surfaces that connect on that joint. So if you were to have a joint that's wore out, you would want to probably take more of the two versus maybe weak ligaments. That's a whole different thing. Okay, type three is the connective tissue, the collagen, that is like the mesh around the liver, inside the liver, that separates the different things. It's more delicate. It's in the bone marrow. It's in the lymph. Okay, that's three. Okay, four forms the respiratory tract, and that's involved in the bronchial tubes, the lungs, the around the intestines, the tissue around the heart, the tissue around the intestines. Okay, that's type four. And then type five forms the hair and the cell surfaces. Okay, those are the different types. So anytime you're buying collagen, there's different types you can buy from different sources. Sometimes collagen comes from chicken sternum. Sometimes it comes from bone marrow. Sometimes it comes from fish skin. Sometimes it comes from pig skin. So it comes from many different sources. Now, the question is it just a matter of consuming collagen to put the collagen back? Not necessarily. There's a couple really important things you need to know. If you're vitamin C deficient, you will not be able to metabolize collagen. Collagen will not form in the body too well. You're going to have weakness within the ligaments, the cartilage, and just if you take a look at a vitamin C deficiency called scurvy, for example, what's happening, they have a lot of collagen loss, they have bleeding gums, their teeth are falling out. What is that? Well, what happens, vitamin C is necessary to form the collagen very, very tightly. It's because if you don't have vitamin C, it can leak blood, and that's called microhemorrhaging. It's the same exact thing that people have in their arteries. So if they have like a clogged artery, for example, the first thing that happens is a microhemorrhaging. So you have the bleeding, the cholesterol comes, the calcium comes, forms a plaque. That's because they have a small version of scurvy in the arteries. So what happens is if you gave them type 1 collagen, it might not work. What they need is the vitamin C. So vitamin C is very important in with collagen. Make sure that you get a natural version. If you're using some synthetic, it better come with a lot of bioflavonoids or other factors, okay? Number two, gastric bypass. If you have a gastric bypass, what's happening is you're not going to be able to digest the collagen as well because your stomach is not as big and it's altered. The physiology is altered. So you might have loose skin. It's hard to get the skin back. Lastly is low stomach acids. If you don't have enough stomach acid, you can't digest the collagen. So you can't even pull it in to break down the collagen that is going through your mouth, whether it's food or supplement, it's not breaking down at the stomach level. So it never gets broken down into small particles. Now, how do you know if you have low stomach acids? Well, you're gonna have gas, maybe an iron deficiency, B12 deficiency, indigestion, acid reflux, and that could be a clue that you need more stomach acid. And all of a sudden, the collagen that you're consuming from your food is working, okay? So I just want to kind of give you some insights on the different collagen types. And it might not be a matter of just consuming collagen. You might have to look at these other factors. All right, thanks for watching.